Bonsoir Stacy, bonsoir James. This is a lesson we had yesterday. Leçon 6 sur 36. Quel jour sommes-nous? Nous sommes le jeudi 3 septembre. So remember the day, the number and the month. Quelle heure est-il? Il est 19h. Il est 7h. So I give you like a shortcut here. C'est tolérable. So this word ends with a able, so able, it's gonna stay the same in French. So confortable, we have an N instead of an M. So comfortable, confortable, probable, for instance, probable, able, the same drill, possible, possible, impossible, impossible. So Delph, page 12, we studied the time. Il est 1h, il est 13h. Il est 1h15, 1h15, 13h. Il est 1h30, 1h30, 13h30. 1h45, 2h moins le quart. We can also say 13h45 if you want. Il est midi, it's noon. Go to translate. Il est minuit, it's midnight. Il est 3h pile, it's like, exactly 3 p.m., 3 a.m., etc. So I'm asking you to do the seven activities on page 12 and 13 of Réussir le DELF A1. There is also a picture. No, I don't add it here. So you can find the correct answers at the end of the book, but I'm not asking you to do that. Okay, up. I think I went a bit too far. Okay, so here we did that. Activity 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, actually, the first is not necessarily an activity, it's like a welcome message. And here we can find 3 TGV, des gens, des personnes, un palmier. I wrote the whole thing here. Des gens, des personnes, un palmier, des valises, suitcases, palm tree. Okay. If we talk about the time, we may sometimes have to specify du matin, AM. De l'après-midi, PM, c'est afternoon. Du soir, evening, PM. Ok. This is part of the communication progressive du français. This is page 17, I believe. Non, 16 and 17. So 16 et 17. Ok. We talked about vous voulez dépenser combien? But in fact, we don't really say that is. Vous voulez mettre combien? How much would you like to put? But we don't say put in. We use this verb mettre to avoid to use dépenser to spend. So, démonstrative adjective: this, that, those, these. Ce masculine, cette féminine, ces pluriel. Cette is because the noun starts with a vowel on H and is masculine. So, for instance, if I want to say this man or that man, cet homme. It's masculine noun, but it starts with an H or a vowel. This or that bicycle, ce vélo, because it's masculine. Une voiture is féminine, so this, that car, cette voiture. If I want a plural form, it doesn't matter if it's féminine or masculine. Ces voitures, ces vélos, these cars, these bicycles. A tree is un arbre, in this case masculine, but it starts with a vowel and it's masculine. Cet arbre. C basically means it is or this is. So how can we tell if a noun is masculine or feminine? We may have to learn the endings, but it's not really a perfect science, so you're gonna have to be careful here. Demandez le prix. It's here. You have the recording, so you can listen to the file, which is easier for me. Demandez is to ask le price. Dans une papeterie, so in a stationery store. la vendeuse, the saleswoman, le client, the client. Je peux vous renseigner. Renseigner is to inform. Can I inform you? Do you need anything? Do you have any questions? Oui, je voudrais, I would like to see the fountain pen, pens. Vous voulez mettre combien? How much would you like to put? How much would you like to spend? Je ne sais pas, I don't know. Ça dépend, it depends. Alors regardez ici, so look here. Ce stylo est très joli, joli is pretty. Il fait combien? How much is it? Vous pouvez me dire le prix de ce stylo noir? Can you tell me the price of this black pen? Of course, bien sûr. It's like it costs, it is 32 euros. Et ce stylo bleu là, and this blue pen here, tous ces stylos sont à 47 euros, and all these pens are at 47 euros. Alors, je vais prendre le bleu, so I'm gonna take the blue one. C'est pour offrir, is it a gift? Oui, s'il vous plaît. So, je voudrais voir, I would like to see. Je peux vous renseigner, je peux, I can I inform you? Can I give you some information? Some answers? Vous voulez mettre combien? How much would you like to spend? Vous pouvez me dire, can you tell me? Je vais prendre, I'm gonna take, I'll have. Vous pouvez répéter, can you repeat? So, c'est pour offrir, it's like it's to offer, so it's a gift. C'est pour faire un cadeau, it's to give a gift. C'est pour savoir, it is to know. So, what is it for? It's to know how to collect mushrooms. I don't know. Vous pouvez me dire le prix de, can you tell me the price of? C'est combien? How much is it? Ça fait combien? Total. So you buy different items. Total. How much is it? Les cerises sont à combien? It's a weird one here. So the cherries are how much? Ce pantalon fait combien? These pants are how much? Quel est le prix de? Okay. So I ask you to do exercise 4 and 5. We did 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Le client sait exactement combien il veut dépenser. The client wants exactly. He knows how exactly he wants to spend. C'est faux, for 50. Hein. Le client n'aime pas le stylo à 75 euros. C'est faux, he likes it, but it's too expensive. Il décide d'acheter un stylo bleu. He decides to buy a blue pen. Oui, c'est vrai. Le client veut faire un cadeau. Oui, c'est vrai. He wants to give a gift. Vous voulez mettre combien? Je vais prendre le classeur rouge. Je peux vous renseigner. Je voudrais voir les stylos à plumes. Vous pouvez me dire le prix de ce stylo mine, de ce porte-mine. Je voudrais du papier à lettres. L'enfant dessine avec un stylo, un crayon de couleur, sorry. J'efface, I erase, avec une gomme, an eraser. Il me faut, I need, un porte-mine, mechanical pencil. Je mets les documents dans un dossier. I put my documents in a folder. That's not easy here, but you try your best. You ask for the price of the following articles, so you need to ask every time a different, to use every time a different expression. Okay? So I forgot just one last thing. So you have the activities on the blue book and two more activities here. Un stylo à plume et des cartouches cartridges, stylo bille, bullet point pen en bic, un bic, porte-mine, mechanical pencil, un crayon the pencil, un crayon de couleur, un crayon, not the Crayola, c'est more like a colored pencil, une gomme, an eraser, so gommé, we add an R and we have erase, du papier à lettres, it's like this kind of a fine letter paper, des enveloppes, envelopes, un classeur, a binder, un dossier, a folder, des chemises, files. That is it. Passez un très bon week-end. On se voit mardi prochain. À très bientôt.